That's right. Yeah, as if today wasn't good enough, we have more mild temperatures to start off the work week. But overnight tonight, leading into Monday morning, we do have one little area of concern that I want to make you aware about. It's called freezing fog. So, of course, it is fog, but it forms ice on a lot of surfaces when it does develop. The reason that it's going to happen is because we have this mild air in place. It has more moisture content in it, but the ground is still very, very cold, especially north and west of town. So that allows the temperature of the air just above the surface to cool to the dew point. And then because the winds are very, very light tonight, that's going to prevent that moisture from mixing. So it will stay in those little tiny droplet forms, and then you get this freezing fog. It can cause a layer of ice that makes for slippery surfaces, icy surfaces. Anything that's untreated could be icy north and west of town. Even close to the city, you might discover that the sidewalk or the pavement is wet as you're stepping out the door, and it's not because it rained. It's because of this same concept that's happening, but just not reaching the freezing mark. Notice that north and west of town, we're already below freezing. It's below freezing in Montgomery and Chester, where it's 30 degrees. It's 36 in Kingston, still well above freezing in New Paltz, where it's 39 degrees. We're still sitting in the 40s in Central Park. It's 43 degrees. That is above our average high temperature for this time of year. Some fog is already starting to form on Long Island. The visibility is down to 3 miles in Islip, East Hampton down to 5 miles, 4 mile visibility in Bridgeport. So do be mindful of that as you're heading out the door early tomorrow morning. And here's a look at the temperature that you're going to have when you're stepping out the door. 38 degrees in the city, 30 in Livingston, Chester and Newburgh both getting down to 31 tonight. So you'll still need the jacket, but maybe not all of those layers. You don't need to bundle up too much, especially because the wind chill's not much of a factor and because temperatures are going to be very quickly rising. On Monday afternoon, we get up to 54 degrees in Midtown, 55 in Flemington and Edison, Rock Hill and New Paltz getting up to 51. Same deal in Brentwood and Levittown, 51 degrees with just a light south breeze at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Tuesday is the mildest day of the forecast, all the way up to 58 in the city, 57 in Armonk and Newtown, Glen Cove up to 59, 62 degrees in Rahway. Again, not too much of a breeze, just about 10 miles per hour. Right now, Live Storm Tracker 4 is completely in the clear, but we do have a weak disturbance on the way. You can see it's bringing quite a bit of snow up near the U.S.-Canadian border, but as that same storm system makes its way toward us, it will just be a rainmaker because of how mild it is. Notice the showers that are in central Pennsylvania during the overnight hours, Monday night into early Tuesday morning, practically completely break up as they make their way toward us. So we could see a few sprinkles and showers during the Tuesday morning commute, but then that moves out very quickly and we're back to sunshine and again, very, very mild in the exclusive 10-day, but pretty briefly, 45 on Wednesday, back up near 50 on Thursday, and then into the 50s on Friday. There will be some rain to end the work week, but overall the pattern is looking much more comfortable than what we had to deal with last week. Back to you.
What a difference a few days make, huh?
For sure.
Erica, thank you.
Waiting for customer service. When you need help, you deserve better. Fords better get the care of. Every call, every email answered.
Woo! All right, well, this week, I mean, any golfers out there, Bruce,
you can get 18 probably, in, right?
Yeah, you can probably get a few in.
Yeah, I'm sure that any golf courses that can accommodate people are booking some tee times over the next couple of days. The milder trend that started today continues tomorrow and on Tuesday. A light shower is possible Monday night, but otherwise it stays dry, and the warmest temperatures are going to be on Tuesday when it will feel like spring. Rain doesn't arrive until Thursday, so we have several days of dry weather as well as this milder weather in store. Right now, 40 degrees in, on the Upper West Side. In Hoboken, it's 41, 37 in Harrison, and we're down to 35 in Bloomfield already. So we do have temperatures near the freezing mark in parts of the tri-state, especially north and west. We are below freezing in Andover at 29, right at the freezing mark in Peekskill, 32. The reason that I'm bringing up those temperatures so critically here is because we have relative humidity that is high enough to form fog. And when you have freezing temperatures, you have the potential for freezing fog. The wind is very, very light or non-existent right now, so we have the potential of seeing fog develop overnight tonight into early Monday morning. And here's a look at the visibility forecast. Notice around 5 mile visibility, so some fog will be developing here. North and west of town, there's the potential for a light icy coating on any untreated surfaces. So just be very cautious when you're stepping out the door tomorrow morning. In the city, temperatures will be solidly above freezing, but we still could have some kind of slick roadways. The pavement could be a little bit wet because of the same effect, the freezing fog, except without the freezing part. So it could be just a little bit wet out there on some of those untreated surfaces. 43 degrees by 11 o'clock, and that's just the start of a big, big warm-up that will take us into the afternoon with a high of 54 degrees. Nice and mild with just a few clouds arriving late in the day. We are tracking those showers for you on Monday night. Notice this is very, very early in the morning on Tuesday, 4 a.m. So a light band of showers moving from the north and west of the city through the city, but a lot of the showers dissipate before they even get here. So don't be surprised if you see a few raindrops on your windshield as you're heading out the door Tuesday morning, but you won't need the umbrella because this is not a big rainfall event. The bigger story is the temperatures continuing to get milder. Look at that high in Mahwah on Tuesday, 60 degrees, 62 in Linden, 59 in Freeport, 58 in the city, 55 in Dover. So very warm temperatures on the way. And again, it stays dry for the most part. We are tracking a system that will move through the Great Lakes toward the tri-state, but that's the only threat for rain that we have until Thursday. In the exclusive 10-day forecast, yes, it does get cooler on Wednesday with a high of 45, but it's still above average for this time of year. We don't see temperatures heading back to the 30s until this time next week. Back to you.
All right, Erica, thank you.
Okay, before we come back, there is a special Bruce Beck Sports Finals Super Bowl edition coming up.
Extremes are one of the hallmarks of climate change. You see dry areas getting drier. You see areas that normally have a lot of moisture getting inundated. And heat extremes, cold extremes, all of those things are hallmarks of climate change. Back here in the tri-state, we have a nice start to a pretty calm weekend. It's going to be pleasant again tomorrow, a little bit milder than it was today, and it's going to be about average for this time of year for that high temperature tomorrow. A slight shower chance as a cold front approaches us late tomorrow night. And we are monitoring two tropical storms right now. Neither one is going to bring us any rain in the tri-state area, though. 62 for your overnight low tonight. It's going to be a little on the cool side with those patchy clouds and temperatures in the suburbs getting into the low 50s in some cases. Of course, when you have low relative humidity, that helps you to have a big temperature change from the overnight to the afternoon. And that's what we're going to have tomorrow. We'll get all the way up to 78 degrees, partly sunny skies. We do have that potential for a shower late in the day. Now, there is something really important I need to point out to you about heading to the beach tomorrow. If you're going down the shore, that rip current risk is high, and it is because of one of those tropical storms I mentioned before, Paulette. Otherwise, it's going to be a nice day to maybe stroll the beach or the boardwalk. 66 for your high in Jones Beach, Long Branch 67, Norwalk 68, the Hamptons 65 degrees, so maybe you'll want a sweatshirt or a light sweater. So on satellite and radar, we can see the approaching cold front. That's what's going to bring us that chance for an overnight shower, and you see that here on Futurecast. We're pretty much dry until the overnight, and then around dinner time, a couple of these sprinkles and showers making their way into the metro area. But it's not a lot of rain. We're back to sunshine on Monday. Coming up in the 7-day forecast, I am going to give you a little bit more detail about those tropical systems that we're tracking. Kaidi, back to you.
Looking forward. Thank you. Fire burning in the Sierra National Forest north of Fresno injured about 20 evacuees. Authorities say that fire broke out Friday, then exploded in size, growing to 36,000 acres in just one day.
We do believe that there's still other people out in the wilderness. We'll be continuing those rescue operations to go out and try to find them and get them to safety.
Right now, more than 70 wildfires are raging across several states with no relief in sight. Meteorologists say the extreme weather conditions in many parts of the West are raising concerns that more fires will break out.
We could see temperatures well above the century mark, no rainfall, dry conditions. That is just fuel to ignite more fires.
Wow, they're going through so many extreme conditions, extreme heat out there, while we're enjoying some of the nicest weather we've had all year, Erica.
Yeah, absolutely.
Absolutely. This is fantastic summer weather that we have. But out west, as you did allude to, Kitey, the heat is exacerbating the wildfire risk out there. All this pink shading in California, Arizona, and Nevada is for an excessive heat warning, triple-digit heat in a lot of cases here. And parts of Arizona are also in an extreme drought. So that combination of dryness and heat leading to some really bad conditions for battling a wildfire. Here's a look at some of those triple-digit temperatures. It's 112 right now in Vegas, 109 in Phoenix, even Sacramento right now at 100, and Palm Springs just a little bit inland in Southern California right now at 116. Locally, it's dry, but that's okay because while we could use a little bit of rain, we're not in a terrible drought situation like they are out west. So we can enjoy this nice weekend with clear skies, low humidity, and nice comfortable temperatures. Tonight we'll get down to 66 degrees with
The forecast, a little rain in our system.
Out here on Storm Tracker 4's live red sweep, and we'll zoom into a couple areas where the showers are falling currently. Nothing really heavy, of course, but we do have light to moderate rainfall still scattered in its activity level right now along the I-80 corridor heading from Troy Hills toward Bloomfield and into the Newark area. A little bit farther to the north, we have some heavier showers along the lower Hudson Valley heading into Westchester and Putnam counties. Overnight tonight, we'll continue to see those periods of rain, a warm front lifting through, bringing us those showers. But then, as we get into the work week, there's a potential for thunderstorms. The system is going to be a long-lived one for us. It does have quite a bit of energy, so we're going to look for that potential for on and off rain and thunderstorms, not only on Monday, but also on Tuesday. The greatest chance for thunderstorms tomorrow will be in the afternoon and evening hours. The morning commute could be dry, but then the afternoon and evening drive home is going to be a little bit dicey. Right now in Diker Heights, it's 66 degrees, 63 in Chelsea, 63 in Morristown. We've cooled off considerably with that rain from the low 70s that we reached for our afternoon highs. On our live radar network, you can just see how extensive this system is. It's really disorganized right now, but it is going to start to come together and become a little bit more powerful by this time tomorrow. Overnight tonight, though, we're just going to see occasional showers. Don't be surprised if you hear a rumble of thunder, but for the most part, it's just on and off rain showers with a low 54 in New Paltz, 58 in Flemington, 61 in the Park, and 59 in Massapequa. Winds out of the east-southeast at 5 to 10 miles per hour. And then it gets a little bit breezy tomorrow, especially if you do get a thunderstorm. The breezes will, of course, increase along with that. 64 to start the day with showers likely. By noon, there's a potential for a thunderstorm, and then we'll have periods of rain and storms. It's not going to rain steadily all day long, but just enough showers and periods of thunderstorm activity possible all day on Monday. So here's a look at that with Future Tracker. Starting the day mostly dry, but it's going to be damp. Same deal at noon, but then we'll start to fire up those thunderstorms. You can see some reds and oranges here in the Hudson Valley during that evening commute on Monday. It is during that drive home time that we have the greatest potential for thunderstorms on Monday. Here's the exclusive 10-day forecast. High temperatures will only be in the 60s on Tuesday and Wednesday as we still are dealing with this storm system, but a big burst of sunshine is going to end the work week for us.
Snow cones and mini golf. Summer's here.
I'm Storm Team 4 meteorologist Erica Groh. Luckily, that morning rain cleared out in time for summer streets, and now Storm Tracker 4's red sweep completely in the clear. We'll talk about the return of rain with the new work week. That's coming up in the exclusive 10-day forecast.